Growing up, I had dreams and aspirations, but always felt like the kid that didn't fit in. For the most part, I wasn't a bad kid, but when I made the transition into adulthood, I turned to the streets for guidance. This led to getting locked up in juvenile hall, doing time in CYA, and eventually a 120-month sentence in federal prison. I had a lot of time to think and reflect during my federal sentence, so I share with you what I learned, hoping I can positively influence someone else's life with Prison Talk. Had a question from one of our viewers. Hey, Big Herc, I like what you do. I enjoy the Fresh Out series you put out. I tune in pretty much all the time. My question is, how were the Hawaiians viewed in the feds? Did they get along with the Hispanics, Asians, Blacks, Samoans, Whites? Another question, when you first arrived to the yard or the cell, how would you carry yourself when people say, we got a new guy, and they start making sexual comments or insults? What would you say or do? I know you must check that person, but what if the person you check was part of a gang or your cellmate is one of the homeboys in the same gang? What should you do? One more question. When you sleep, have you ever slept with makeshift body armor on and weapons on you? If so, what would you be your choice? Thanks again, Big Herc. Your first question with the Hawaiians. I was cool. Shout out to Hawaii. I was cool with a lot of Hawaiians in the pen. I fought my case in San Bernardino with a lot of cats from Hawaii, good people. You know, we used to eat together. I busted some spreads with some of the homies from Hawaii. You know, they're pretty much laid back dudes, real loyal, real cool dudes. I was at Sheridan with some cats from Hawaii. We kicked it, you know what I'm saying? Also at Hurlong with some dudes from Hawaii who was real cool people. You know, they ran their own program, you know, did their own thing. They had their own little clique, you know, their own little area where they ate at, ran their own program, you know, just kind of handled their business, man. I mean, you know, guys from Hawaii are real laid back, real cool dudes. I didn't really see any bullshit going on with the Hawaiian car. You know, they in certain institutions, they might, as far as the area they eat in the chow hall, they might be, you know, by the Asians, or and a lot of times the Samoans or other islands or Tongans are, you know, sitting in the same area. But yeah, man, I mean, it wasn't really, I didn't really see any tension with them with other races. They pretty much, you know, handle their business, and depending on whoever was the shot caller, he would determine as far as what direction that car would roll in if some shit kicked off. But you know, the cats I did time with from Hawaii were good people, man. As far as somebody making sexual comments and trying to sex play you, that's a no-no, man. That's a wig split. You know, nobody is gonna outright come up and sexually play you your first day on the yard unless you are a known punk. You know what I mean? If you walk around, if you just, you're just, you know, you're setting it out there like you're on some booty time, you know, like you're trying to give up the booty. But ain't nobody just gonna come up to you and press you for no reason, or, you know, sex play you or something like that, man. You gotta lead on to that's what you're into in order for that to happen. And you know, as far as, you know, your cellmate being part of a gang and the gang member pressing you like that, usually as soon as you hit the yard, somebody will approach you and kind of like, you know, if you're Hawaiian, a Hawaiian cat will approach you, or if you're Black, somebody will come up to you. And what happens with when people when you get booked in to the new institution, whoever is doing, there's usually an inmate working at the booking, and he sends word out that, hey, there's some cats here from LA, you got some dudes from Hawaii, you got two white boys, you got a couple guys from Northern California on the yard, some Norteño, or you got a couple, you know, five Serranos rolled up. I mean, believe me, by the time you hit the yard, you actually, everybody knows your business already, because these motherfuckers are on it, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna be hiding out thinking ain't nobody gonna know where you're from or what you're about. I mean, people are gonna know, and they're gonna say, hey, go holler at this cat, he'll hook you up with a cellmate, or talk to so-and-so, he'll talk to the counselor, get you in with one of your partners, and that's how it works. So it's a lot of internal stuff going on with the inmates who kind of like run the institution on a micro level. And as far as, you know, sleeping with body armor, you know, I slept with my boots on. You know, I've had a blinky on me, you know what I'm saying? next to me when I'm sleeping, just in case shit kicked off. I had to jump up out of a sleep and you know, stick a motherfucker or something like that. But I never had like, you know, magazines taped to me or anything like that. But as far as sleeping with, you know, body armor or being prepared, I've had my boots on, I've had my khaki outfit on, you know, I had a, you know, like I said, I had a blinky next to me or in my hand while I slept. You know, just took precautions that would, you know, make sure, you know, that I was prepared in case somebody did run up or if I felt there was tension in a particular dorm unit, you know, you just got to be ready. So, you know, but there are guys, you know, I've seen when, you know, shit kick off. If you know that there's going to be some real shit jumping off, you might get a bunch of magazines, strap them to yourself, you know, in your waist. You know, at that point, you got you a serious, you know, blinky that you're gonna use as your weapon of choice. And, you know, you're gonna get ready for combat, and that's what's up. But, you know, you always stay prepared. You never underestimate any situation as far as when you're in jail, because the softest places can have the most violent people, you know, when provoked. So you gotta stay on your toes as far as that's concerned. But yeah, I hope that answered your question. And I wanna say thank you for tuning in and supporting our channel.